Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. In the last part we went back to the king, upgraded our level a little bit, and as you can see we are now back in level 6, about ready to get down this ladder and down these anvils into level 7. It might look like the entrance to level 7 is another one of those where you can't get out at first glance, but actually if you time it right you can make a jump right up here and get back up the ladder. So the entrance to level 7 is actually not as scary as it looks. Another thing, we are pretty close to death, so let's get healed before we get into level 7, because like I said earlier, the monsters in level 7 are going to be a lot stronger than the one we've been facing so far. Although, to be fair, not all of them, some of them are actually pretty weak. So let's see what a red potion does these days. As you know, we bought a couple for about 5,000 gold back at the king's town. So let's equip one and see how close we can get with just a single heal. We can have up to almost 300,000 hit points, and we now have 25,000, so let's just use one. Pretty close to 250,000 hit points in a single heal, and that's because we upgraded our wisdom to 85 now. We can thank our viewer Zenith Moon for the prodding me to invest in wisdom again a little bit. I was actually kind of ignoring it for a while. I still stand by the fact that in the early levels you don't really need the wisdom, but later on, as you can see, clearly it's going to be very useful. Especially because a full heal at this level costs, I think, close to 20,000 gold. So having a full heal, almost full heal for 5,000 is definitely a good bargain. And since we already collected so many red potions in the previous levels, I think we have close to 50 of them, we'll be able to use them a little bit more frequently, and we are very much going to need it, because the monsters from here on in are going to be tougher and tougher, and our weapons and especially our armor isn't going to be upgraded for a while. See, our halberd has some pretty good experience on it now, our tilt spell has good experience on it now. Our full plate is still a little bit lacking, which is good, because that means we still have a lot of room for improvement there. You can see our defense is now over 13,000, but it's going to have to rise a bit more before we can confidently fight the monsters in this level. So let's get in here. Already you can see that a bunch of these anvil blocks are blocking our way up, and the only way back into these exits, both to the previous level and to the next one, is through these anvils, which means we can only get in here from the top. So we have to find the top of the level and then find the right path down these anvils. Second annoying part from level 7 is these blocks. Almost the entire level is filled with these squares. I'll show you a little bit by running around in them. And if you feel like they look a little bit endless, you're not entirely wrong. And the reason for that is that they are filled with teleports. Oh, this is the other side. As you can see, this is the entrance on the other side, and we can't get in here either. And this is actually the... let me just get rid of these guys first. X-Beaks are a good one to start with, because they don't have a strong physical attack, they have a magic attack, but if you upgraded your magic resistance properly, they are not a big threat at all. So for level 7 creatures, these are definitely the ones you want to fight first. This is actually an exit if you take a wrong path from above. Or this is one of them at least. You can end up here. Oh, another one. As you can see, we can take these guys out without taking very significant damage. And they drop a nice bit of gold, so yeah. Main reason I'm doing it now is for the experience though. We need more fighter experience, because we've let it lag behind way too much. So yeah, now I'm completely on the other side of the level. The interesting bits you really want to find in this level are at the top. So let's try and get all the way to the top. And let me just hope that there's not too many teleports here, but I think there are, because yeah, we are completely lost, but we're not. Okay, so just keep moving up and to the right and eventually you'll end up here, and this is where you want to be. This is the entrance to the tower area. So like I said, about 3/4 of the level is filled with these blocks. Oops, and that's another teleport, as you can see, which I wasn't really planning to go then, but oh well. Especially because these boobries, they are pretty strong. Still not the strongest monsters in this level, but yeah, definitely critters I want to use my spells on for the time being. Thankfully the first and second spawns just drop golden food, so you can easily just use your magic attacks to kill them. Oh, I went down back in the same teleport. And I'm lost again. So like you can see, it's very easy to get lost in this level. Oh, here we go. This is the one I wanted. Ah. Made the same mistake again. Yeah, this is the one I think, yep. Now what we want to do is, this crawler you want to ignore, because once you fall down this hole you won't be able to get out, similarly to the rock louse we saw earlier. What you want to do is run across this gap and then run across this one. These sendums again are not very strong, so we can kill them quite easily. Just keep pressing right and you will jump across this little gap as well. And then we will start opening some doors. Now apart from the squares area, this is basically the only other part of the level that's important. Because this is where, of course, healing and keys, that's always good, but this is where most of the monsters hang out, and also where we can find the single tower for this level. There's only one tower in level 7. No, don't hit me. Yeah, I don't want these guys to hit me because they are strong as well. I think they do like 30,000-40,000 damage per hit to us right now, so I'm going to try and avoid any physical contact. Especially because they don't drop any item that is particularly valuable to us. If I'm not mistaken, they drop spectacles, so spectacles are not worth getting hurt over. Almost the same is true for these grells. Let me check real quick. Yeah, they drop a rod, and we're really not that interested in experience with our magic spells anymore for the time being, so we can just zap them as well. And again, these guys will do quite a lot of damage. These are not quite as strong as the dragons or as the crawlers, but they are still pretty powerful. Although I believe, yeah, you can hit them from the side and not get hurt too bad. And as you can see, they do indeed drop a rod. These guys are important too, but mostly for the reason that you don't want to attack them. These are karma monsters. They have some pretty good drops, but they also give you a lot of karma if you kill them, so just avoid them. And this is in fact the only tower in this level, as I said before. Now the way in here, do I have enough time? Actually, we're coming close upon the time limit, so let me just show you a little bit more of the level, and in the next video we'll take a look at the tower, which is also kind of a special case. Oops, ow. Yeah, see, clearly these guys are pretty damn strong. Be very careful about attacking these guys. Thankfully, we have so many potions that I don't have to worry too much, but yeah, you don't want to get hurt too much unnecessarily. And again, as I said, a rod from these guys. Grails don't drop anything really important, so you can just magic them away most of the time. Fire drakes, the first two spawns you want to just shoot because they drop spectacles and because they have a very powerful physical attack. But after that, I will show you the next spawn. The first two spawns are physical based, but the next two spawns are magic based, and as you can see, their magic attack is pretty weak actually. Mostly because we have a good magic resistance, but even so. And that makes them ideal for fighting with your melee weapon, both for the experience and because they drop black onyxes. Black onyx is not the most important item in the game, but still very nice to have. Similar to the fire gem we were using earlier, they are mostly convenient and will sometimes help you avoid having to spend other items we go. Oh yeah, and the third one was a glove. I believe the last one is a red potion, so might as well just pick that one up as well. If you notice, these guys move similarly to the slimes from level 1, which means you can usually hit them from the side without getting hurt, although sometimes creatures will look like they're moving that way, but they will instantly change direction as soon as you come near them, as this one just did, if you noticed just now. So it looks like you might be easily able to kill them from with a side attack. That might not actually be true. I'll show you one more time. So this guy, I'm going to wait until it moves past me, and then try and hitting it from the side, but as you can clearly see there, it still damaged me pretty badly. Now the final spawn is a red potion, so maybe that's kind of worth taking some damage for, just because the red potion obviously is going to heal more than the damage you take from it. Yeah, I think that's all of them. Now there's these boobries. These are also very cool because they drop winged boots, and winged boots, as you know, are extremely valuable. The only downside is they are pretty damn powerful themselves as well. So for the time being, I think I'm just going to avoid them. What else? Yeah, so if you go down here, as you can see, you'll end up getting stuck. Oh, damn it, I got teleported again. But eventually you'll just either get stuck or you'll get pooped out into the block area again. Show you one more time. So I can go down here. If I were to go down any further, I believe that's where you get stuck. Unfortunately, I can't show you because of the stupid teleports. Or actually, maybe I can. Wait. Okay. So this is what teleports us. Move off. Move back on. Move off. Move back on. Is this what teleports us? No. 1, 2, is that what teleports us? No. 1, 2, 3, and that one? No. This one then, probably. Yeah, that's the one that teleports you. So if I get on it again. Oh, here we go. Yeah, see, this is the way down. Oh, it ends up on this ladder. So it's not completely, you won't get completely stuck, but you'll just end up back on the side here. And that's true for most of those anvil paths. You'll end up somewhere where you weren't planning to be. It might not completely get you stuck, but it won't help you either. So this is really the way to go. If anything, you want to get up here. These guys have a lightning attack, which is a little bit stronger than the magic attacks we've seen so far, but it's still not really impressive. Again, a good creature to build up your fighter experience with. And I think they dropped some pretty interesting items as well, although I'm not quite sure what it was. Oh yeah, magic gloves. Well, nothing too important, but we'll pick them up anyway. Okay guys, I think that's about the time limit we have. We've seen some of the monsters we'll be facing in level 7. In fact, I think we've seen almost all of them already. That is because the tower is kind of a special case in this one. But I'll show you that in the next part. So thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you in the next one.